Let me show you how you can create a PowerBI.com account using an email address which could be Gmail, Outlook, Hotmail, Yahoo, even AOL. I'm not going to judge you, my friend. So you probably have tried this where you went to PowerBI.com and you clicked the start free or try free and eventually got to this, which said, hey, to get started, enter your work email address. And well, you know, you maybe tried your gmail.com only to get this message that it didn't work. So we're going to show you the best workaround for this and how you can get started here. So leave a comment after you watch this video and let us know if this workaround worked for you or not. I'm Avi Singh, a Microsoft MVP and best-selling Power BI author. And if you want to become a Power BI pro, make sure to subscribe and click that bell so you are notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. All right, so let's get started and look at what this workaround is. But before that, let's take a step back and I just want to make sure that we're all on the same page. So first of all, let's make sure we understand that Power BI Desktop is always free. PowerBI.com account is also free, but with a work email, and that's what we're going to talk about. Now, there is PowerBI.com Pro, which is a paid license, and Premium, which is something different. So in this video, we will be talking about this one. Then how do you get around this? If you don't have a work email, if you just have a Gmail address, how do you create a PowerBI.com account? Now, if you are more interested in Power BI Desktop, then I would highly recommend, or maybe you're just getting started with Power BI, or if you keep getting stuck, then I would recommend that you check out our number one ranked Power BI tutorial, and we're going to link it in the corner and in the description below. We also have a video specifically talking about licensing and the Pro and Premium and everything. We're going to cover that later. So let's get in here and let's see how we can solve this problem. Again, if you try it with the gmail.com, it doesn't work. So we're going to solve it using this three-step approach. And I guarantee that this is only going to take you about 15 minutes worth of effort. Now, as I take you through these steps, I'm going to show step by step. I'm also going to be sharing some useful tips. Now, there may even be a faster method, which unfortunately I only discovered after I had recorded the steps for this video, but I will tell you about it in the bonus section at the end of the video, so make sure to hold on for that. Now, as for this video and these steps, what I would recommend is that you watch it twice. The first time, I just want you to watch the whole video and decide whether this is an option for you or not. And if you decide this is an option, then you can come back and watch the video and follow along step by step as you go through the steps and, of course, pausing as much as you need. Now, as you can see here, our first step is getting a domain name. Now, here, what I'm going to say is that if you are maybe between jobs or if you're a freelancer, hey, you are pretty much your own company. So getting a domain may even be a good idea anyway. Now, if this topic is of interest to you about becoming a Power BI consultant or growing your Power BI consulting business, then do check out our playlist on that specific topic. And we are going to be adding more videos to that. And we're also looking for ideas from you to add more videos on that. So again, the links are in the corner and in the description below. Okay, so let's get started with our three-step process. And the first step is getting a domain name. It's going to cost you almost next to nothing. The site that I would recommend is namecheap.com. Now, folks, I don't get paid by them. I'm just a happy, happy customer. For one, I would say avoid GoDaddy if you can. I just haven't had a great experience with them. Namecheap is really simple, really works, and they got a great support team. All right, so you're going to go to their website. You're going to search for a domain name. In this case, I'm searching for powerbibizhelp.com. And my tip here is going to be that don't obsess over getting the right domain. This is just for getting an account on PowerBI.com. You can always come back and get the domain name that you really like or you really love after you've given it a lot of thought, especially if you're going on the path of becoming a Power BI consultant. So you search for the domain name, find one that is available, you know, you add to cart and you complete the purchase. Here, the tip I'm going to share with you is that on this page, you might notice the promo code. If you are interested, just Google Namecheap coupons. They have monthly coupons running all the time and they save you not that much, but hey, every penny counts, right? So if you're interested, then just Google Namecheap coupon and they always have an active coupon. So now with your domain name set up, we're on to step two, which is to set up the email forwarding for your domain. For this, I would like you to Google just the words Namecheap email forwarding, and that should lead you to a full article which shows you step by step exactly what you need to do. Now, hey, since we're here, I'm just going to cover you and show you the steps, for one, to emphasize how easy it is. So in Namecheap, once you have the domain, you're going to click manage for that domain, and then you want to go to the advanced DNS tab at the top, and within there, find the mail settings and change that to email forwarding, and make sure to click save all changes. After that, go back to the main domain tab, and in there, you should see a section which says redirect email. Here, you should click add forwarder. And now this is where you can specify an alias. So you already have the domain name powerbibizhelp.com. And in this case, I'm specifying an alias, which is just my name, Avi. So that would essentially give me an email address, avi@powerbibizhelp.com. And then I specify where do I want it forwarded to. And of course, here is, in this case, I'm using a Gmail address, but you can use your Outlook, Yahoo, AOL, whatever you have, right? So, and of course, make sure to check the box at the end. So in the next step, we're gonna be using this email address to sign up for Power BI. Now, although there might be a pause here, as Namecheap says that it may take up to an hour for this email forwarding to be set up. Now, while you're taking a break, might as well check out this new site, powerbibizhelp.com. This is actually a new site that we set up to offer free Power BI help to businesses impacted by COVID-19 crisis. So maybe just take a second and navigate to the site and find out more details. And of course, if you qualify, then reach out to reach out to us using the options on that page. Okay, so at this point, I'm also gonna share some tips with you. So my first tip here is it's actually possible to set up multiple forwarding emails in this manner, just as you did. In fact, if you look at Namecheap documentation, they mentioned that it's possible to set up to 100 forwarding email addresses, and theoretically you could use each one of them to create a free PowerBI.com account. And the next tip is that if you're testing the email forwarding, then make sure to use a different email address. So don't send the test email to, let's say, avi@powerbibizhelp.com from that Gmail address. Namecheap specifically says that probably would not gonna work. So find something else, maybe Outlook address or something like that, to test that. Okay, so with that, let's move ahead with step three, which is using this domain email address to create Power BI account. Now, this is a standard Power BI creation, but now you're over this roadblock. So this is the part where we're getting stuck, where it said, hey, you have to enter your work email address. Hey, friends, pound your chest and proudly enter your newly created domain email address. Now, this time, it might ask you to verify your identity. This may change based on location, but it did ask me to do this. It asked you one more time, did you get your email address from your company? Again, proudly click yes to that, because again, if you're a freelancer or between jobs, I say you're a company of your own. And here, creating an account is this section. That is where our email forwarding helps us out, because it's going to tell you that, hey, we have sent a verification code to the email address you specified to the work email, and you need to enter that in. All you have to do is, well, at least in my case, it was being forwarded to my Gmail address, so I popped over to my Gmail and copied the verification code and entered it in. Okay, that was my daughter who parsed in. Okay. All right, let's keep going. Next it asks you to invite more people, which I just skipped. And voila, you are into PowerBI.com. So there you go, folks. You have seen the steps here. Now, I had promised that bonus at the end, I'm going to cover possibly an even faster method. But just a reminder that, again, if you're interested in Power BI Desktop, check out the desktop tutorial, which I had linked earlier. And I promise this one, if you're interested more to learn about the pro and the licensing premium, how does that work? We're going to link to that video right now in the corner. And of course, all the links in the description. And again, a reminder that we also have the Power BI Consultant playlist, which we would like you to check it out. Okay, so what is this faster method? Again, folks, I discovered this only after we had recorded the steps for this the process. And frankly, I'm not sure if this is faster. And you know, I do like the domain method because that, again, if you're going on this path, getting a domain name might be a good idea anyway, all right? But this option comes from, you know, our favorite folks, GynaCube, and their suggestion is that you can also accomplish this by signing up for an Office 365 Enterprise trial. And the easiest way that I found was to just Google Office 365 Enterprise, ignore the ads at the top, and just look for something that says compare Office 365 Enterprise options. And that should show you the options. And I think you can make this happen either by signing up for the E3 or the E5. But hey, if it's a free trial, might as well sign up for the E5. So, and basically what this does is sets up an account for you with like an on microsoft.com email address. Now, if you do want to watch more step-by-step in more detail, I'll link to the GynaCube original video, which covers this in more detail. Hey folks, so we are always looking for new topics to cover, so let us know what's going to help you, and we'll be happy to create videos on that. And of course, make sure to join us live for our Talk Power BI Q&A as well. You can find out more information at talkpowerbi.com. Click to watch our next videos and make sure to subscribe. And until next time, power on.